Hi everyone, this is Miss Chrisman, and this is your word study video for Thursday, June 4th. In our video today, I'm going to teach you another project that you can do at home. You can do it today, or you can save it for a day over the summer when you feel like you need something to do. And it's going to be a way that you can use writing to express how you're feeling in your heart and to help other people see things the same way that you do. Today, I'm going to teach you a way that you can use your writing to make a big difference in the world. Before I do that, though, it's time for shout-outs. I want to give a shout-out to Sarah in Rochester because look at this awesome memory game that she made from our video yesterday. She did such an awesome job of making her card so nice and neat and making a really fun game that now she can play with her family. Before we go on to what we're doing today, I want to tell you that there's one more game that you can use those cards for. So after you make your cards for your memory game, if you're done playing memory and you're looking for something else to do, you can also play Go Fish with those same cards. So you can pick up your cards and you can ask the person you're playing with, do you have the word and? And if they do, they give it to you. And if they don't, then they say, go fish. And you have to pick a card and see if you can match up your heart words in the game Go Fish. So try playing Go Fish with those cards and let me know how it goes. For our activity today, we are going to use writing to make a big difference in the world. And we're going to use our writing to be able to tell people how you feel and to make a change about how you want other people to feel. We're gonna do that by making signs. I wanna show you some signs that kids have made in the past so that you can get some ideas about what you would want to write on your sign. You might have also seen people on TV right now that are marching with signs or holding signs that show how they're feeling. So some of the signs I want to show you are this one from Zaya that she drew this year. It says, everyone is unique. So that was a message that Zaya wanted people to know, that everyone is unique. This is a sign that we saw out on a walk last year that says Black Lives Matter. And that was a really important sign that we saw right in our neighborhood near school. This is a sign that Aiden made last year, who's in first grade now, that says, don't give up. So that's how he was feeling, that he wanted other people to feel like they never give up. And this is a sign that Nisa made that says, care about each other. So that was the message that she wanted people to know, that they should care about each other. Lewis made a sign that said, be kind, everyone. And JJ made one that says, love everyone. So those are some examples of signs that have some really strong and powerful messages. I want you to take a second and think about a sign that you would want to make now so that you can send your message to other people and they can feel the same way that you're feeling when they read your sign. Once you have your idea for your sign, the next thing you need to do is get your materials. I like to use a piece of paper that has no lines on it. So if you have that, you might want to use it too. An even better thing that I don't have, but maybe you do have in your house, would be like a big piece of poster board. Or if you have like a cardboard box, you can cut the side of the cardboard box and you can write on the side that has no writing on it, because it will be easier for you to hold up so that people can see it. The other tool that would be best for you to use is if you have thick markers at your house, because you want to be able to write a sign that people can read from far away. And we're going to talk at the end of this about what you're going to do with your sign so that people can read it. But the one thing you have to remember is that you want people to be able to read it from far away. If you just write it in pencil really lightly, people aren't going to be able to read it when they're far away from you. The sign that I'm going to make today is going to be a sign that says Black Lives Matter. And I want to write that because that's something that I want
everybody who passes by my house to be able to see and know that I believe that. So I'm going to put it in a window in my house for people to see when they're walking by when I'm done. The first thing I want to do is just map out on my paper with my finger where I'm going to write Black Lives Matter. Now I'm thinking about the kind of letters I want to write them in, and usually I just want to write in small and neat letters, but I want this to really stand out. So I'm going to write in big uppercase letters that people are going to be able to see and read, even if they're far away. I'm going to speed this up now so that it can go a little faster and you can see what I'm writing, but a little bit faster.
Be a higher love down in the heart or hidden in the stars above. Without it, life is a wasted time. Look inside your heart and I'll look inside mine.
Now that I have the words on my sign, I could be finished, but I also want to decorate it just so that people know that this is something that I'm really passionate about. So I'm just going to make some rainbow colored hearts on the side of the sign like this. One heart right there, one heart right there, all in rainbow order. I'll speed it up again so that you can see me do this, but it will go a little faster.
What could be over? Bring me a higher love. Bring me a
Now I have my sign and I can tell everybody how I feel using my writing just from looking at this sign. There's a few different things that I can do with this now. So like I said, I want to hang it in my window over there so that when people are walking by, they'll be able to see it in our window. But some other things that you could do, you can hang it on like the door to your room. If you have like a door to your bedroom or something like that, you can hang it on the door to your house so that if anybody's coming in or out, they can see your sign. Or you can put it on a stick and you can walk around with it and show people how you feel. I found out the best thing to use for that, to put it on a stick, is actually like an old paper towel roll. When you finish all the paper towels and you just have the cardboard left, that's a good one because it helps it stay up without flopping over like this. I cannot wait to see your signs. So please, 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 please think about what message you want to tell people. Make a sign and then send me pictures of it because I really want to see what's in your heart and how you're spreading your message to so many people. I can't wait to see it.